Welcome to another episode of Clean Eating Hacks. I'm your host. My name is Pia Maffei, owner of IamACleanEater.com, and also we're here in the kitchen of Artisan's Palette, and we're here with Sharissa Bradley, and we're also here, we have a special guest today, and our guest today is Taylor Weber, owner of Harvest to You. And we're our CSA here in Southern California. We're coming to you from Temecula, and we're in the month of October, and we have asked Taylor to join us today to talk about what's in season and what his company does. So we're going to start that conversation now, and Sharissa's here, and she's going to start building a soup while we're talking, and I'll explain the soup in a second. So we have some questions for you, Mr. Taylor.
All right.
Let's first talk about your company. It's a CSA.
Yes.
Describe that a little bit.
And
to us.
So we are considered an aggregate CSA, and what that means is we work with several different local farms to bring extremely fresh picked organic fruits and vegetables right to our community, right to people's homes in our community.
Awesome. Now, you've seen on our videos before that we're always talking about Harvest to You and how we get our box here in the store and how we also get it on our homes.
Oh, yeah.
Chris is also a big fan. And so I'd like to dive into the box right now and see what is in season. So let's walk us through it, please.
All right. So this is a Harvest box that you'd see at your front door after we ring the doorbell and bring it by. Depending on where you live, we deliver on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And we have, again, it's all freshly picked organic fruits and vegetables. And because it's fresh and local, everything's obviously seasonal. And so we are extremely blessed here in Southern California in the sense that we get 52 weeks a year of growing season.
Yes.
We can grow all year long, so it's great. That being said, as the seasons change, as the temperatures change, the produce changes. And so we get, throughout the year, a really nice variety of lots of different fruits and vegetables. As we're coming into the winter months, we're going to see some winter squashes coming on. One of the squashes we're going to be using in the soup today is butternut squash. We'll see acorn squash, delicata squash, lots of different winter squashes that are going to be available throughout the cooler months. Also lots of greens, lettuces, beautiful kales, chard, lots of greens, arugula, and we also have some citrus and some other different kinds of fruits here and there as well. And so we brought a box that we're delivering today. This is an example of what we're delivering to our customers today.
What size of box is this?
This is the Family Harvest. And great question, Pia. We have a couple different size boxes. We have a Personal Harvest and a Family Harvest. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean it's for a single individual or for a family. It just kind of depends on your produce consumption in your household. We were trying to be clever with the name instead of calling them small and big. So, and we also have different delivery frequencies. So again, based on your household produce consumption, you can choose from a weekly delivery to every other week to even every third week delivery, as well as being able to choose the different size of boxes that
we
have.
I love that you can change and customize for yourself. How many total farms do you work with locally?
On a weekly basis, we work with about 6 to 10 different local farms. Now, in our database of multiple farmers that we have throughout the year, we work with about 25 to 30 different local farms throughout
the
year.
Because they're all growing different things, so you want to deal with somebody growing limes, then you'll know who's growing limes and make that part of the harvest box, right?
Yeah, one of the great things about being connected with that network of farmers is everyone grows in a slightly different microclimate, which allows them to grow a little bit different things. That gives us the ability to provide a huge variety of different produce to our customers.
Yeah, amazing. I love that idea. And how generally, since you said the microclimates, how big are these farmers or farms that out of the six that you've chosen for this month, how big are they generally? Well, how many acres do they have?
Most of the farms that we work with are growing on less than 10 acres.
Okay.
And we really have maybe a handful of farmers that are growing on 10 acres, and most of them are actually less than 5 acres. So
wow,
fairly
awesome.
fairly small plots, yeah.
And we'd like to say they're above organic, right? Because they're not even using any type of herbicide or pesticide that's approved.
It's 100% naturally grown produce.
That's what's so important to make the distinction here. Because we always like to say, oh, let's buy organic.
Sure.
But there's still a couple hundred different approved herbicides and pesticides that are approved for organic, where they're picking farmers, these smaller farmers, that aren't using any of that, correct?
That is correct.
Yeah.
That is correct.
Love that.
Organic is important. What's more important is fresh. Once a piece of produce is picked out of the ground, off the tree, off the vine, it starts to die. It starts to lose its nutrient content, and so if we can consume that produce within 7 days of picking, we're really getting the highest nutrient content from that produce, which only adds to our wellness.
Right, and it becomes more like a superfood at that point because it's so filled with nutrients.
Exactly.
So I see we've got chives here.
We've got some garlic chives here. Beautiful garlic chives in the box this week. We've got some parsley, beautiful parsley.
Oh, it is so beautiful parsley.
Huge.
Yes.
We've got
all the lettuce
mix, bag of salad mix. This is a customer favorite here.
Yes.
Yeah, that's my favorite.
It's my favorite every week.
We have some amazing, tasty arugula.
Oh my God, that is my favorite. I'm telling you, I did
wonderful
such amazing
salads.
On one of our episodes, we did, Sharissa and I did caramelized peaches.
Yeah, I was just going to say peaches.
Okay, so it's hard to get peaches right now. They're just at the end of their season. But if you caramelize the peaches with the ghee that we have, especially the vanilla bean ghee, and then you make a salad, okay, with the beets, the arugula in the center with pecans. I just did this. I entertained again over the weekend, and it is such a beautiful, easy, delicious hit. The arugula is so nutty and peppery. Okay, what else do we have?
We have a couple fruit items in our box this week, and these are sapote fruit. And this is a tropical fruit typically grown in South America. And we have been cultivating the trees in Southern California for a little while now. But really, this is an item that you can only find really in tropical areas, warmer climates. So we're not gonna find these up north. We're not gonna find these
so
on the east coast.
So it comes from a tree called the sapote tree?
That is correct.
Is it C-A-P-O-T-E?
S-A-P-O-T-E. And there's actually a couple different, depending on where you live, there's a couple different ways to say it. In South America, they say zapote with a Z.
Okay.
And again, they're referring to the tree that the fruit comes from.
Okay.
And that's the name of the tree.
I want to give you a hint. I had no idea what this was. We got it last week, right?
Yeah, we got it last week too. It's just
and
sitting
like,
in my
what
basket.
Is it? I don't know what it is. This is what's so fun to get the box. And to find out what's in season and finding out something so random that you would never buy probably because you don't know what it is.
Or
how to use it. So the first thing, some tips for you if this happens to you. Just cut a piece and eat it right away and just say like, what is it? What am I getting from it? We decided to use it raw in the store and we did a side. We did it with radishes that are in season and cabbage and we did a slaw with apple cider vinegar and olive oil and a little salt. We just kept it simple, okay? Now, we're making a soup over here and maybe we'll just add it in the soup too because I'm a big fan of adding fruit into soups. So that's another idea for you. And if you have a juicer, you can probably juice it perfectly fine too, right?
Yeah.
Is it pretty sweet? I haven't tried it yet.
It was sweet to the inside. It was good, yes. Yeah. It was so interesting, the flavor. It was almost like an apple. When you open it, it's like white.
Oh.
Inside. Yeah, so I was like, oh my God, is this starch? And it, you know, and so it was just, but when you walk through it, again, we're always telling you, don't be afraid of the food.
Play with your food.
Play with your
love that. We love to encourage people to experiment with different things.
Yeah.
And we love providing the not so normal items. And we just ask that you just give it a try.
Yes.
You know, if you don't like it, hey, we can adjust your order for next time, and that's okay. One of the things that is really important to us at Harvest to You is to not only provide this fresh produce, but to provide the tools for you to use the produce to make it tasty. On our website, www.harvesttoyou.com, we have a recipes page. And a blog page where we have storage tips for the produce so you can get the best life out of it.
Really?
We have tons and tons of recipes on there, so if you're not quite sure how to use the item, check out our website and search on our recipes. You can search by item and pull up all the recipes for that specific item. We also provide images on our website and the list of all the different produce, because again, we may bring something that's not so common. We want to be able to tell you exactly what that is and how to use it. And another great thing about being in such a cool network with Pia and Sharissa and other like-minded, healthy-minded people is we have access to that. So if anyone has questions about any produce items or about any recipes, hit us up on Facebook, hit us up on Instagram, and we're connected with Artisan's Palette and Sharissa and tons of other people as well who just
have a clean eater.
Oh yeah.
And I am a clean eater, and all of these people who just have a wealth of knowledge when it comes to this stuff. And so if there's anything you need, just ask us. We're happy to help out in that sense.
So I want to interrupt one second because Sharissa's making this amazing soup and my mouth is watery and we see this melon. I have to show. Okay, this is beautiful.
It does.
But I think
really
we need to taste it.
Okay.
I think we just need to get a little knife and taste it. So this was a melon that came in our box about 2 weeks ago. And as I said, I'm a big fan of putting fruit in soup. So, oh my God, thank you. It's cold. So delicious.
That's great. That's really good.
It's really delicious.
Mm-hmm. I love cold fruit. I don't know about you, but I love when it comes out of the fridge, the flavors that comes out from it.
I love it, but my teeth don't.
No, I understand that, but
it's
so
refreshing.
Good.
At least
so
it's soft enough, you know, you're not like, ah.
Yes. So as we're building this up, I'm going to explain what's in the soup in a second, but we want to finish up here with what else is in our box. So this came a couple weeks ago, so this is done now, right, Taylor? We're never going to get this again?
Well,
next year.
Yeah, we'll get it when they come back in season. The melons are definitely a warmer month fruit, and so we've just kind of moved out of that season.
Okay.
And so we won't see any more melons until next summer.
But that's okay because we want to eat what's in season.
Exactly.
Awesome. Okay, what else do we have for us?
We have some pomegranate. These are going to be a staple fruit throughout the cooler months.
Love it.
Pomegranates are awesome.
I have to ask you, when are persimmons coming?
Persimmons
are my all-time favorite.
Persimmons.
Next to peaches.
Yeah.
Persimmons are now in season. We've just come into the persimmon season, and so we may actually see them even in next week's box.
Okay, perfect.
Next week, the week after.
Cassava flour persimmon spiced cookies.
Oh,
unreal. My favorite winter month treat.
Okay.
Totally clean, so delicious. We're going to make one here.
And
oh, yeah.
I make
oh,
for Thanksgiving,
yeah.
I
so
do
cool.
persimmon and cranberry.
Yeah.
And it's, oh my God, so good. Yeah. Okay, what else do we have?
We have some
radishes.
Beautiful radish.
Wow, they're
awesome.
Huge.
Beautiful. We use them a lot in the slaw. But also, you know, I grew up on radishes. We would just have some salt, and in fact, get some good salt. The Icelandic flake salt's one of the best one. Cut it in half, dip it in the salt, and eat it.
Oh,
trust
yeah.
me, it sounds weird, but do it. You'll
oh,
thank
no,
me later.
Line.
Thank
awesome.
Me in the notes.
Thank me in the comments.
We've got some curly kale here.
Oh, yum.
We're going to see all different kinds of kale throughout the winter. The kale loves the cooler months. This is typically something that we can grow all year long, but they really do thrive in the winter months, the kale plants do. time. So again, we're gonna see lots of leafy greens, which again, we have tons of recipes to use those leafy greens on our website. One of the healthiest things that you can eat, one of the healthiest things for your body is kale, leafy greens.
Yes.
It's the best for you.
Yeah.
We have butternut squash, and this is another customer favorite.
Oh, I love
we love butternut squash. Yeah. It's just
But I love how awesome. You can get, like, you're just seeing the different sizes and seeing how it's not perfect.
Right.
We've got cherry tomatoes. We've got a little package of cherry tomatoes there. And tomatoes, this is another thing that we can grow all year long here in California. We grow all different kinds of tomatoes. And we've got cherry tomatoes in the box this week.
And I've got to say, this is a lot of food.
Yeah.
This is what you're getting.
It's a big box.
A lot of food.
Every time,
okay? For not a lot of money.
It's a big box.
That is so much value.
We as a company, we saw a need for farmers market quality produce conveniently delivered to people's homes. Not everyone can make it to the farmers markets. We love people to go to the farmers markets and encourage them to go meet the farmers and just go be with your community and hang out with the kids and
support
the local businesses, support the local farmers. And for those people who can't always get down there, that's what we're here for.
Yeah.
We're here for that. So we work with those farmers at
the
farmers market.
And the convenience
going
straight
to
your home.
Exactly.
That's the point. Yes,
exactly.
Love that.
And then we've got the last item in here is jujubes. This is a jujube fruit. This is one of our lesser common items.
Yes.
And
another one where people go, what do I do with jujubes? But Sharissa is going to tell us what to do with jujubes.
I think that jujubes are one of the most amazing superfruits to make into a tea.
I
sliced them all open so that they were just in half. Not all the way open, but just a little half. Threw them in a big pot like this. I had two packages. I had my last week's and this week's. And I threw them all in the pot with about a gallon of water. Cinnamon sticks, vanilla bean, some clove, and I just let it cooks for 4 hours. So it just simmers down, it turns this beautiful, like, golden brown color, and I've just been drinking it this as much as I can to help. I mean, this is the best. We were talking earlier about emergency packets, like, do some jujube tea, you don't need any emergency packets.
Oh my god, we don't promote that at all, no.
No, we don't, but I'm saying, like, this is your emergency, your... get yourself through flu season, eat these, like, the green leafy vegetables and the pomegranates and all these beautiful things, and make yourself something beautiful with the jujubes.
Yeah, jujubes, you're absolutely right. They're one of the highest vitamin C contents in those little teeny fruits.
Yeah.
So they are very good for you. There's lots of different things you can do with the jujubes.
Absolutely. So that's a sample of our box. What we're going to do is we're going to invite Taylor here almost every season, the different growing seasons, to see what's in season for us in Southern California, so you can get some tips for that. So you'll see him again in one of our episodes. And so I know you got to run with the family box. So we've got your website, which we'll put in the notes. It's www.harvesttoyou.com. And then when you go there, you're going to see different family packs, the pricing, what you can get. If you're watching us from another part of the country, we strongly recommend that you find
Absolutely.
A harvest to you similar to them.
Absolutely.
Do you give advice on your website of partner places that do what you do, maybe in like Missouri?
We can. We do have a network of lots of local, national farms, I should say.
Oh,
sorry.
Good.
And so we can connect you with some people.
Okay, great.
Tibet, absolutely.
And that's through your website?
Yes. You can contact us through the website and let us know that you're looking for local CSA in your area and what area you're in, and we'll do our best to hook you up with someone.
Because right now they are going from Temecula down to San Diego. So you'll do all of San Diego County?
We do actually all of North San Diego County.
Okay.
And then we go north up to Riverside, and we do most of Southwest Riverside County as well.
Okay, so that's a pretty decent area.
Yeah.
Are you doing San Marcos? I had a customer.
We are.
Okay, so
we are.
So where does North San Diego County end for you? You're going to the coast as well, Encinitas and
So what we'll do is we'll go south down 15, uh-huh. and we'll go through Fallbrook, Escondido,
okay.
San Marcos, Vista, Oceanside.
Okay.
And then we'll head up. We usually head up around college.
Okay.
We usually head up around college, and then we'll come down the 76. Back to the 15 and then head north to Temecula.
So that's covering quite a few of you.
Yes.
So if you're in that area, or of course anywhere in Riverside County, the Temecula, Murrieta, Hemet.
You do Hemet?
Yeah, mm-hmm. So I mean, any of these areas, you can obviously go to Harvest to You, Harvest number 2, the letter U.com. Otherwise, then find the CSA finders and type in your zip code. And it's not just farms. Vegetable and fruit farms. You can actually find your meat this way. You can find other high quality dairy products this way. So there's a lot of really great resources to find people who are still doing things the right way.
Yes.
So you don't get
overwhelmed.
Good advice. I know, especially with the classes that Pia and I do here in the store, it can get a little bit overwhelming now that you know what the bad things are. How do you do the good things? We're so grateful to people like Taylor who are doing the right things and jumping through all the hoops for us so that
yes.
we have the highest quality ingredients that we can make things like soups and salads and things for you here in the store, as well as for your own family at home. So please check them out. Do yourself a favor.
One more thing. Also, what's huge about these guys is they will deliver eggs.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
High quality eggs. And the hens have not been fed corn or soy.
Right.
So they're plugged in for that. So that's, Charissa gets her eggs from
there. I get my eggs from there every week.
Yes.
They have a variety of other artisanal products. So
they do.
So just go to their website, check out their information, check out the blog, like you said, the recipe page. If you're ever concerned about what to do. When I first started getting my Harvest to You box, I think now almost 6 years ago, I have a picture of my daughter sitting on the counter with all my stuff when she was only like 4 months old. She was holding on to a kohlrabi, and I had never seen it before.
Yes, I love kohlrabi.
And now it's one of my favorite things
yes.
to make into a coleslaw, and I do
yes.
it with apples yeah. and citrus and make this beautiful coleslaw. So it's opened my eyes up to a whole new realm of things. There's so many fruits and vegetables, and we limit ourselves to the 5 that we find
yes.
in the grocery store. So give yourself that range of color this winter.
Absolutely.
Get yourself the farm box so that you can at least see what's in season, and get this education. It's invaluable.
Thinking of sapote, kohlrabi,
yeah.
radish,
jujubes,
and this in a slop.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. It'd be so good.
Beautiful.
When our kohlrabi's coming.
That's a great idea.
Back.
We will
January?
See them very soon.
Very soon,
we'll
okay.
see them very soon.
Oh, we'll add persimmon in there.
Oh, my gosh. Now you're calling my name.
And if any of you watching the video, if you guys are concerned you may not be within Harvest to You's delivery area, we have a zip code finder on our homepage. It's the first thing you see when you go to our website. You can punch in your zip code. It'll tell you whether we deliver to you or not.
Awesome. Okay, I'm going to let you pack up this box. We're going to get to our soup here, and I can explain what's in the soup in a second. Taylor, thank you so much.
Thank
we love
you,
having you here.
Thank you, Charissa. Appreciate it, guys.
Of
Thanks,
course.
Everyone. If you guys have any questions, please comment on the post. And Pia and or Charissa will pass that along to us, and we'll make sure we communicate with you guys. Thanks again.
Thank you.
Thanks.
So we're carrying on here with the end of our cooking episode, and we want to show you. You know, our motto here all the time is let's not be afraid of the food,
yes.
right? So we've added some ingredients that maybe you didn't think of adding, like a melon, add to the soup. So I like to layer, you know, our ingredients. So we started with onion, and then we went to cabbage, then we went to butternut squash, then we went to melon, and it's all in this tandoori masala. We're gonna add some water next and then let it boil. The water we use in the store is all from Mount Palomar. So we've got that worked out. And that's another local resource that we use here. And the water has so many minerals and it's just one of the cleanest waters that you can get and beneficial for our system. And so we're gonna go ahead and add a couple, four cups,
yeah,
probably four to five cups of water. And then we're gonna let that boil and come up to a simmer. And we'll do that for probably 45 minutes. And then once it's done, we're gonna put it in the Vitamix. And in the show notes, we'll have a picture of the soup completed so you'll see what it looks like. But we know we're not afraid of our food. In fact, we've never done this recipe before. And it's okay, because that's the point of seeing what's in season, what's in our box, what came out. We know it's gonna be delicious. How's it not going to be delicious?
I mean, the smells are overwhelming. Yeah. It's so beautiful in here.
Right.
And then, of course, when you do something as beautiful as the tandoori masala,
yes,
it just brings all those flavors together, because it's sweet, it's spicy, it's tangy, it's
yep,
a little tart. You really just can't go wrong. And we're blending this so the textures aren't gonna make any real difference.
Right, right. So you will be excited to try the recipe and also watch the image of it. It will be mouth-watering, I'm sure.
Oh, yes.
Thank you so
much.
Till next time, we'll see you.